Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to the Chemet webinar on our Chemet polymer capacitors. My name is Alexander Nebel and I will moderate the webinar today. We are very pleased that you find the time to join our webinar. Presenter today is Mrs. Jekaterina Steil von Holstein, our field application engineer in Central Europe. Hello, Jekaterina. Thank you for presenting today. Please tell the audience shortly about your role inside Chemet, and then you can directly start your presentation.
Thank you, Alex. Hello, everyone. As was already told, my name is Jekaterina Steil von Holstein, and I am a new FIE of Chemet in Central Europe. I freshly graduated from university with a master's degree in power systems engineering in October. And since beginning of January, I work at Chemet. Today, I would like to share with you information about the topic tight MLCC time, polymer can come to rescue. Since I started at Chemet, this was the most interesting and fascinating topic for me, where we from Chemet still see a lot of potential to help our customers. And here, on the next slide, you see the presentation overview. We will talk about MLCCs and why they are so frequently in use. And then I will introduce to you basics of polymer technology, giving you also an overview to Chemet polymer products. And then we will see how their polymer products can come to rescue by looking at the footprints of both technologies. And at the end, I will give you a case and example which will prove that replacements are not only possible but also available for your wallet. So let us start by admiring that MLCCs can be found in most electronic devices and applications, as they can be used due to the material characteristics, as well as in high voltage, as in low voltage ranges, and can have up to several hundred microfarad. So MLCCs can achieve high capacitances, and they can also be used for high temperatures for up to 200 degrees C. Besides, high voltages can be reached by part of approximately 2000 volt, and ceramics as well as MLCCs can be used as safety caps. They are also applicable for wide band gap purposes, and all these aspects they make MLCCs a brilliant technology. Considering also the low price, there's a question: why are there still other technologies on the market? Actually, there's also a but for this technology. Class 2 ceramics and lower, they cause piezo noise due to their ceramic nature and are not very robust to withstand cracks. Besides, there can be, there will be effects like DCBS, aging, and temperature dependence, which have to be considered while planning the electric design. The capacitance can decrease from 100% to lower than 20%, which are then measured in the application. And this is the reason why a huge amount of MLCCs are necessary to cover the capacitance, taking more space on the PCB for the required capacitance. Besides, there can also be MLCC shortages, which occur more or less often on the market. And if you consider that you want to launch a new product, this surely does not provide relief. In this presentation, we will concentrate on polymer technology, which is a very good solution for the MLCC issues up to 75 volts. With approximately 1 to 100 microfarad. But first, let's go back to basics. What is tantalum technology and why do we have tantalum polymer technology on the market? Both technologies have, of course, a similar anode, or it's a similar anode. It's a press porous pellets of tantalum. So both technologies are tantalum based, but we call polymer only polymer. And this porous tantalum allows also a high surface, and this is how relatively high capacitances can be reached. Also, the dielectric is the same. We have tantalum pentoxide for both capacitors, but the difference makes the polymer. This is a conductive polymer material, and which allows also different behavior and different performance in comparison to mangan dioxide, standard tantalum capacitor material. So, for example, in current through fault, the heat for standard tantalum may ignite the capacitor. Because the manganese dioxide oxidizes easily to manganese trioxide, but the polymer material does not have this reactive behavior. And also polymer shows less failures. The fit rate is smaller in comparison to standard tantalum capacitor. And this is also the reason why the recommended voltage is for polymer higher in comparison to standard tantalum. So we have for polymer 80 to 90% recommended voltage, while we have for manganese dioxide only 50%. In order to understand it properly, you see in the right corner an example. So for a 5-volt application, a 10-volt tantalum capacitor would be necessary, while for polymer, only a 6-volt cap is enough, which also has a smaller size and also saves space on the PCB due to the low D rating. Besides, the polymer capacitor have much lower ESR over the frequency in comparison to tantalum manganese dioxide ones. And the polymer technology allows to reach higher capacitances and also to let them be stable over the frequency. So as you could see, polymer capacitors promise to be very interesting technology and to have a really good performance. And this is also the reason why Chemet Electronics offers a high portfolio of polymer tantalum products. By the way, Chemet is number one producer and supplier of polymer tantalum products, which we call CoCap. And we offer various series for different approaches. For example, our standard series begins with T5-2 at the beginning, where we have high voltage series, which is the highest voltage is 75 volt. We have high temperature series, we have high capacitances and reduced volume series. Some of the series are even available as stacked chip, which provide higher capacitances and a lower ESR. Also for our automotive customers, we offer polymer automotive products, which are ACQ200 qualified. And also here we enlarge our portfolio, and I would like to highlight that this Monday, the T597 series has launched, which is a capability series in small case size. And the T591 for 2000 hours test for 85-85 finally was released. This product is the first on the market of its kind. So now CoCaps can be used in powertrain applications and high demand applications in humidity. So now that we know the basics of both technologies, how does this promised replacement work? And here two considerations have to be taken into account. The first one is the case, where we already have planned an MLCC footprint on the PCB. But we do not want to redesign the PCB. We just want to use this MLCC footprint. So for the 0805 series, we have the T597 capacitor, which is now launched. For 1206, we have the S case, and the B case can be used for 1210 MLCC, but some adjustments have to be made. All other series, a bigger footprint series, where the PCB has to be adjusted where it is required. So now we come to the second consideration, as the polymer caps can reduce place on the PCB by replacing whole banks of MLCCs. And I will show you using a real life example how it can be done. Here we have an automotive input filter application. This overvoltage protection circuit controls an external N-channel MOSFET. And here we take a close look at this input filter in the right corner, inside the red circle with 22 microfarad, where we already see that the 22 microfarad ceramic is planned. This is how a typical input design of an automotive electronic control unit looks like. And at this point, we would like to put our capacitor of 22 microfarad. The voltage between the clamps will be calculated for this application as 13.4 volt. And a typical value for the frequency is, for example, 100 kilohertz. We have here also high temperature condition, as normally when we have this kind of application, also we have higher temperatures. And now we would like to compare these two technologies, which one of them is best according to the application's conditions and to the performing. I've chosen two different capacitors, both 22 microfarad, and both, of course, automotive grade. For the MLCC, we have an X7R, a class 2 dielectric capacitor, which is frequently used in this kind of applications. And for the polymer, we have a typical 22 microfarad, 35 volt capacitor. In order to compare these two technologies and also to look at the performance, I used our KSIM tool from our website. And this tool helps me to simulate the behavior of capacitors depending on voltage, temperature, and frequency. So I have put these conditions into the KSIM tool. And now I just use the one-to-one relation. So I compare one MLCC X7R to one polymer, and we can clearly see that due to the derating effect under the given conditions, the MLCC only has 5.3 microfarad left at 100 kilohertz, while our polymer has a higher capacity due to temperature rise and has a capacity of 24.2 microfarad. So we already reached the desired capacitance for our application with one polymer capacitor. So how many MLCCs do we need to put in parallel to reach this capacity? The answer is 4 to 5 X7Rs. Four X7Rs would get us 21.4 microfarad. If this is enough, this is good. Five MLCCs, just for your information, would get us 26 microfarad. So for our input design, we would have the following structure, showing that the number of MLCCs is four times, at least in best case, four times higher than the number of polymer capacitors. And if you think that we have in this kind of application several filters, we will have to have a four times of capacitors inside our application. Of course, you can imagine that this can also have an impact on the costs, and also calculated the cost with 4x7Rs in best case. The prices are all according to DGK, so but you can also use any other platform like Mouser or Octopart. This is just for you to make it clear. The prices are from yesterday, and the price per piece of a capacitor shows that of course an X7R is cheaper. But if we use at least four capacitors in comparison to one polymer, this is more than double of the cost. So we can save in this case 62.5% of our price. Please consider this is just an example. It's not necessary that a polymer can help, but in some cases, even more than 10 MLCCs can be replaced. So in order to get to this price savings, several things have to be taken into account. First of all, the number of capacitors to achieve this target capacitance. As I already mentioned, the DC rating, the temperature, they all have to be considered. The application voltage and the application frequency, as well as the ripple current, all have to be taken into account. By the way, polymer can handle ripple currents of up to 2 to 3 ampere RMS, stack technology even higher. And also the geometry requirements are of interest, not only the footprint, but also how much space are the PCBs available, what about the height. And here I have an overview to make clear when a co-cap may be a good consideration for your application. You have to answer the following questions about the total capacitance. Is the total capacitance higher than 680 nanofarad? Do we have a voltage of over 75 volt? Can I have an ESR in my application of more than 10 milliohm? Is the frequency higher than 1 megahertz? And like, do we have high reverse bias? If you have answered these questions according to these arrows, CoCap might be a very intelligent consideration for your application. So for more information, if you want to have more information about this topic or about other technologies, about other products like other capacitors, inductors, chokes, filters, sensors, actuators, please go to our website. You can also use tools as I have already shown to you the KSIM tool, but we also offer other design tools like KLIM on our website. And if you have any specific question, please do not hesitate to ask your CAMET FIE or your local PM. I hope that this kind of gave you an impression that a CoCap might be a really intelligent consideration. And yeah, thank you very much for the curiosity, for your attention.
So Yekaterina, thank you for presenting today, and to all attendees, thank you for listening today. Please watch our Engineering Center. We will have 2 webinars per week on Monday and on Wednesday, always on the same time. You can directly register on our Engineering Center and also see what's coming up next week in May. Yekaterina, thank you for presenting, and hope to see you soon again.
Thank you very much. Hope to see to be there again. Thank you very much. Bye.
Okay, goodbye.